And you know, before I go on the Super Bowl stage, I'm just stressing and worrying, and you know. And then when I come off, I realize it's all done, and what did I even enjoy about it?
Not even that, you closed out the Grammys.
But that's why, because it's like she's doing the Super Bowl,
and I'm thinking about the Grammys.
She's thinking about the Grammys.
And then I'm doing the Grammys,
she's doing
and I'm
Grammys.
Thinking about the NBA All-Star game.
Yep.
And it's like, that's the only thing. I've gotten to a very good place, though, and all of my friends and, like, mentors in the game, kind of, they've been, like, reaching out to me and, like, trying to encourage me because for some strange reason, they knew how, you know, frazzled I used to be. Mm. And every time I tell people, no, I'm really good, I'm really happy, I'm really at a peaceful place, it's almost like they don't believe me. So I thought the other day, I'm like, you know, I must have been really, really worried a lot. Mm. Because, like, people who know me very well, they're like, are you sure you're okay? But I really am. I've never been this happy. I'm so proud of this album. I'm proud of myself that I will not allow anyone to scare me out of my true potential. It's a scare tactic.
What is Nicki Minaj's purpose? Because, I mean, from the outside looking in, I think you're a very blessed individual because you got two things going against you. Number one, you're a female. And the female hip-hop division was non-existent before you started popping. Mm. And then you're from New York. It's a lot of rappers from New York that aren't popping right now. So you got those two things against you. So being that you were able to break through that and be the big superstar that you are, it's like, okay, she's obviously here for something. Mm. You know, I think it's a bigger purpose than maybe you even know. But what is Nicki Minaj's purpose?
I have to pray on that. I think that my purpose will eventually be related to some sort of a movement for my fans, really. Mm-hmm. I've always had this dream of having, you know, like a Nicki Minaj YMCA type of thing. Just because when I was young, well, everybody knows my story. We didn't have a lot. And, like, we really were going to, you know, free lunch was the thing. Like, oh, we could get free lunch. Oh, we going to free lunch. This was, like, dope. So I remember those moments, and I always play them back in my head. And I used to think to myself, Dad, I wish there was, like, a place that we could also go to, like, to go swimming and to do this and to do that. But things were moving so quickly and my parents were so, like, not really stable, and just my father being an addict and all that stuff. It made it so that in a lot of ways, I feel like I didn't really have a childhood. Like, so when I see kids, it melts my heart because I'm, like, looking at them and I'm like, wow, they'll never get this moment back again. And they'll always remember this time. And how do we as adults optimize it for them right now? You know what I'm saying? Whether they have money or not. So I think that one day I would like to do something for them, for kids in the inner cities, for them to have a place where they can go to and have a place where they can have, like, not only recreation, but schooling, tutoring. Like, you know, I remember I was really, really smart in school, and I think, like, my mother took that for granted. So she wouldn't really sit with me and take the extra time to, like, give me that extra push. But I think that kids need that. You know, it's weird because people would never expect me to be so, like, into, like, children's education and stuff like that. But that's real shit. I don't just say that because it sounds good. I really am interested in learning how to build the education system. Mm. You know what I'm saying? To a point where we have a more of a success rate in terms of black children that go from high school to college. Like, I feel like college was not something that was, like, engraved in my brain.
Like, you gotta go to college.
Right.
You gotta go to college, yeah.
Right. I don't feel like that ever happened. And so many, you know, all my girlfriends, really, well, not all, but most of my closest girlfriends, it was just like once they got out of high school, they figure, oh, well, we good now. We out of high school. Well, I got my GED. I'm good. And I don't want my fans to think like that. So, you know, I have such a great rapport with my fans. When they see me, like, they really be bringing out their bachelors and their masters. Look, Nikki, look. Because they know how important it is to me that it's okay to have fun. I'm going to give you the raunchiest verse sometimes. But I also want you to realize that it's for a time. Word. And one day, you're going to look back and think, wait a minute. Did I really lose my life clubbing and miss out on you know, a moment where I could have been building myself as a woman and having something to offer my children? We got so many girls right now, they having children, don't even know how to, you don't know the first thing to say to a child.
Yeah, they're children themselves.
Right.
Yeah.
But you're just having a child because, you know, I want to keep this dude or it just happened, or I want to get us to the place where it doesn't just happen, that we're smarter than that, that we're the ones in control. What happened? Like, why are we never in control? Why are we always stuck with a baby? Why are we always stuck on the welfare line? Why are we always stuck having to beg, borrow, and steal to provide for our children? Why do we think it's something wrong with waiting to have a baby, waiting till you're 35 or 36 to have a children? You know, technology has changed. You can wait.
Word.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Have something to offer them. But anyway, so I don't know. But that's something that's dear to my heart, doing something that make children feel like I don't have to rush to grow up. I can enjoy my childhood. I can have somewhere to go for free for recreational purposes and for schooling purposes. That's my bigger goal in life.
How do you stay humble? I mean, I know you keep a tight circle. You keep guys like Scav Beasy around. Well, I'm going to ask Scav, how do you keep her humble, Scav Beasy? Do you ever see her getting a little bit extra?
You want to know what's so crazy? Like, yesterday, remember I was saying to you, I was like, yo, it's so crazy. Like, she's so famous. Like, if she goes out, anytime we go somewhere, whatever, like, it's such a freaking chaotic zoo movie. Like, the other day we went to like a carnival. We thought we were gonna be able to be in there for like and just go on some rides and nobody notice anything. Like within like 7 minutes, like the whole park knew. So then we were there for like 10, 15 minutes and we got out. But I was just like, yo, she really hasn't changed. Like she really don't act like I'm this person, I'm that person. Like, yo, she just be there just looking so oblivious to what's going on. Sometimes like she doesn't even know that she's famous like that. And just it doesn't faze her. She really like hasn't changed a bit.
Pay attention to that. How did you escape being more than just an ass?
We said that the other
like,
day.
No, seriously.
We said that the other day. We was like, yo, before I was just a rapping butt.
A butt with lyrics.
Word. How did you get out of that?
Because I created a brand.
Niggas is nice. That's why.
You know, I think that people take for granted how hard this is. So first, let me just say, shout out to every woman and man that's won. It's very hard. Mentally, this shit is draining and draining, okay? And for you to be able to go up there and make music that people love and do interviews with a smile on your face and act like this shit ain't getting to you, it's draining. It's crazy. You know, that's why so many of these, you know, the artists go on drugs or, you know, become alcoholics. When I was coming up, I never understood it. I used to be like, what? They're so ungrateful. Why are they on drugs? Why don't they fucking appreciate their success? I would kill to be where they are. Until you get here and you feel like, oh my God. Lord, is this the price I gotta pay if I really want this? And he's like, yup. Now let's see. Now let's see who really want it. You know, but I think that I became more than that because people cannot deny, at the end of the day, people can't deny that.
You're the shit.
That I
say it. You don't got to be humble.
People can't deny
you
that.
You be like, listen, Ray J. I'm tired of being humble.
Yeah.
You don't need cocky shit.
No, yeah. I'm not a cocky person by nature.
Scaff, be cocky
shit,
for her.
Yeah, man. You bitches ain't shit, man. You need to just really, when you see her, just like get the rose petals, just like she said before, throw that in front of her feet. you pour out the champagne, feed her grapes. You know what I'm saying? If something needs to be sucked, you suck it.
What? What would need to be sucked? On you?
Hey, anything, anywhere. I'm in these streets looking for work. We what? All in these streets, we looking for that work, that twerk.
I just want to tell you, Nikki, I think that you're very necessary.
Thank you.
I think you represent something way bigger than hip-hop. I think that you're going to take hip-hop to new levels. And I think, like, how Jay-Z took it to heights and made people be like, damn, hip-hop can take it this far. I think you're taking that baton, and I think you're going to take it even farther.
Thank you.
So keep doing your thing, ma.
Thank you, darling. Charlamagne Tha God signs out.